Barcelona, wonderful big city, culture, history, a lot of people, tourist traps, the beach. This city has everything. But ladies and gentlemen, today we are not here to enjoy the tourist traps. We're not here to enjoy the many beautiful historical sites. No, we are here for this event right here. Because ladies and gentlemen, right here in Poble de Español this weekend, we will be witnessing the festival Be Prog My Friend 2017, and it's promising to become quite a festival indeed. Before we go to the festival, I think it might be a good idea to show them what our trip was like. What do you think of that, Alex?
Who wants to see that? It was amazing.
It was awesome. Really. It really wasn't awesome, was it?
Nope.
Nope, not at all.
But they don't know that.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, here we have Be Prog My Friend. This is the fourth edition of this festival. It has become kind of a staple in the prog world over the years. It has grown considerably with each edition. Bigger bands have joined. And in this year's edition, we're going to have major acts like Berylian, Jethro Tull, and we're also going to have, well, smaller but up-and-coming bands in the scene like Jardin de la Croix and Caligula's Horse. So really, there's something for everyone in this situation. Another important thing about this documentary is that it's meant as an overview. I'm not going to put in full songs by the bands because I don't want to spoil anything for all of you guys. It's genuinely meant as an idea. So every band will get a featurette with a bunch of minutes of video from the ranging the gig that they're playing right here. But obviously, I'm not going to post full songs. Just want to put that in as a little exclamation point. Also, I will be announcing the bands, telling you where they're from, what kind of music you can expect. Then afterwards, you will get an immediate feedback once the gig is done. I'll give you guys my impression of what I thought the gig was like and what it was like. And that's it. That's the unfiltered version of what you're going to get. So this documentary is going to be pretty raw on the nuggets, but I figured that's the best way for you guys to experience this festival. Start of the festival, as you can see, not all the audience is in yet, not by far. But the first band we're going to see on this, well, on this documentary and on this festival is Caligula's Horse. They're from Australia, and as far as I know, they describe their music as progressive metal with alternative rock influences. Personally, I've never seen them live before, so for me this is going to be a first time, and I'm kind of excited. So let's see what this band brings us today.
We'll be right back.
was Kelly Gillis Horse Live here from Be Prog 2017. And as far as I'm concerned, that was a lot of fun, actually. I didn't know what to expect. I never heard the band before. So it was quite fun to see what they were bringing to the stage. And a lot of people really seemed to like it. Next band we're gonna get is Animals as Leaders. Now, for those of you who don't know what Animals as Leaders is, it's a three-piece instrumental prog metal band that basically does stuff that is incomprehensible, and science is still trying to find out how they actually do it. What else can be said? Dustin Abbasi is considered to be a guitar legend, but I think you can basically say that the whole band are legends in their own right, because with the three of them, they make an immense sound, and I'm really looking forward to seeing what they're going to bring to Be Prog 2017. So let's see what they're bringing. Gentlemen, which was quite an intense performance, an hour of instrumental progressive metal madness. Pretty intense, I would say. Personally, for me, I think an hour was a bit long, but that was my only criticism, because they played tight, they played well, and well, most of the audience really seemed to dig it, so I'd say that's a plus, and that's what it's all about. Next up is, well, I think one of my personal favorites of this weekend, because next up is Mike Portnoy's Shattered Fortress. I mean, holy shit! That's like all the material, all the Dream Theater material I love the most, performed by Mike Portnoy and the guys from Haken, and maybe some special guests, and Eric Gillette, obviously, which is awesome. So it's gonna be quite a feature. So let's see what the guys will bring us, and let's see if the Mike Portnoy Shattered Fortress experience really is as good as everyone keeps saying.
Reality. I'm sorry.
Mike Portnoy, Shattered Fortress, and I'm here with a good friend from Spain. What is your name again, sir?
I'm Pierre Furor.
Pierre Furor?
Pierre Furor. Pierre's Fury.
Okay. Oh, that's you. That's you. Okay. And what did
my father, the name my father gave me is my name, my own name, you know?
I think it's a good thing to have your own name. I totally agree with you.
Sure.
And we just saw Mike Portnoy, Shattered Fortress, and I think you can say the best what you thought of it. What did you think of it?
Wow, it was amazing.
That was fucking awesome, right?
Good musicians, the presence of Mike Portnoy, and a better singer than James Labrie. Don't put this in the video.
I'm not gonna put it in the video. That we're not doing that. Anyway, totally agree. Mike Portnoy came kick ass with everyone here. It was fucking amazing. The next band is, well, not a tiny band either. The next band is Marillion.
Marillion.
So that's proving to be
more than Marillion.
Yeah, I know, right? I know. So the next band is Marillion. It's going to be pretty friggin' awesome as well. So hope to see if Marillion can, well, top this, because Portnoy put the bar pretty fucking high, I'd say.
Yeah, but I guess Marillion is a very classic band. And this emotionally is something, you know.
Yeah, I agree with you. I totally agree with you. So let's see, Marillion, here's to you. Let's see if you guys can rock it. Invisible bird. I have become the invisible man.
Stand perfectly still in the middle of the road. I hold my nerve. I hold my nerve. But the car's
So that was Marillion here at Be Prog 2017. Personally, I think Marillion did an amazing job. It was a really tight set list. Very daring, might I say, playing a lot of epics and longer songs tonight. My only piece of criticism would be that perhaps it would have been better if they switched Marillion and Mike Portnoy's Shattered Fortress around in terms of intensity. But that's really all there is to it, because it was an amazing show. It was really well done.
Joins the light of the moon.
And now it's time for the final act for the Friday, and that's going to be Over. Now, Over is a very special act, which, well, is not exactly standard in any way, considering they started as a black metal band, then they went all artsy, then they did prog rock, and now I'm not entirely sure on what planet they are inhabiting, but it's going to be interesting nonetheless. So, it's here now. I think it's about what? It's like 12 something, right? What time is it? You got it, right? You have a watch. You have a watch.
It's almost 12:30.
It's almost 12:30. It's, well, we're heading into the nighttime now. Oliver's going to give us about, I believe, a 1 hour and 15 minute show, so it's going to be quite interesting. Let's see what this brings us. Here's Oliver. Gentlemen, this is Oliver playing in the background, and we are signing off a bit early this time because of sleep deprivation issues, among other things. But just wanted to say that Oliver is leaving quite an interesting show, a weird show, might I add, but weird can be good, and the audience really seems to dig it. What can I say? It was a very interesting first day, very dynamic, ranging from the intensity of Mike Portnoy's Shattered Fortress, the lovely melody of Marillion, to this, well, experimental weirdness that Oliver is providing. And I think we can say that this was a very successful first day, and I'm looking forward to the next one. So see you guys tomorrow.
And now for something completely different.
I think there's a pun in that.
Do you think so?
I think so.
Barcelona? Barcelona?
Nah, no. It's a bit negative. Barcelona.
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 Yay.
Yay.
Kick the bicycle.
So this was our hotel, a very spacious hotel. They kind of wanted us there permanently, but we politely declined the offer.
And you got some nice bracelets.
Yeah, we got nice ankle bracelets out of it. I'm so confused right now. Right now.
Painless tattooing.
Waiting to get tattooed. And we have a loud soundtrack along with it.
That's the worst part, actually. When I had these tattoos, for instance, it was thicker skin, so actually it felt like someone just gave you, I don't know, like a prick from a mosquito or something.
Mm-hmm.
This is very thin skin underneath your arm, so I already knew like this is gonna sting a bit more. It's not really hurting; it's more like an annoying sting. You know?
Painless tattooing?
No, what was painless for them?
Perfect!
Alex. Barcelona?
Barcelona.
Prog My Friend 2017. We are here once again at Pueblo de Español. Today we're going to have an insanely exciting day, I think, because we're having Devin Thompson, Jordan Delacroix, Anathema, and Jeff Rotol, and much, much more. So it's really promising to shape up to become a good day. We'll be right back. shout out to La Croix, a Spanish band that I haven't heard of before, and to be honest, I feel bad because it was pretty fucking awesome. I'm not sure what the next band on the planning is. What is the next band on the planning? You know that?
It's Devin Townsend.
Is the next one Devin Townsend? Is it going to be Devin? The next
it's
one on the bill.
It's Devin himself.
Woo! Devin Townsend, ladies and gentlemen, who's going to be performing Ocean Machine in its entirety. That's at least what he promised us. And hopefully a lot more awesome material. Personally, I'm a huge fan of the Canadian Idiot myself, so I can't wait. Let's hope that this is going to be awesome. Devin, here we go.
Because you're up here as a professional musician going, fuck yeah, fuck yeah! Being a prog metal guy. How'd that happen? I have no idea. I really liked Motorhead. And because I didn't get laid as a high school student, I learned how to do sweep arpeggios, so... What has 100 balls and fucks old ladies? Bingo! Yeah? How do you get 30 Canadians out of a swimming pool? Time to get out, guys! Because we're kind of passive, we're like, okay, hey, we fucking didn't realize we were in the pool for that long. Okay, this is not awkward at all. Thank God for my emotional defense mechanism that makes me absolutely non-present at this moment. Moint. Moint is Canadian for point. Fuck you.
Mike, so can I get an equivocal yes or no that we're going to be starting in a minute?
Yes!
What changes has thou seen? There where the rolling street rolls hath been the stillness of the central sea, the hills are shadowed.
Mr. Devin Townsend just basically left an awesome impression. Devin is a pro. He's one of the best performers in the progs industry right now. And, well, he once again, he proved why, because he had all the technical difficulties in the world, and he just made a really big comedy show out of it. Now, you gotta be a real fucking giant to pull that off. So, thank you, Devin, for an amazing show for laughs and also some tears. I saw quite a few people being very emotional about this set. Thank you so much. Anathema is next, and that's not the tiny band we're talking about here. A lot of people are excited about Anathema playing here. I see a lot of t-shirts walking around here.
Anathema for all the Dutch people.
Anathema for the Dutch people, yes. Because for some reason they suck at pronouncing it properly. But the next show is going to be Anathema. I think that's going to be pretty emotional as well. So let's just see what it'll bring us. Here we go.
Like I knew you before. And my love, well,
Anathema, ladies and gentlemen, here at Be Prog 2017. We're almost nearing the end, but there's two bands left for us. What can I say? Anathema delivered a very emotional and intense performance, as is by now standard for them. This was my first time seeing them, and I must say, I was pleasantly surprised. What I did see, I loved quite a bit, so well done, guys and girls. Next is, well, a classic band, same as we had Marillion yesterday, because up next is Jethro Tull, the one and only Jethro Tull. And I think I speak on behalf of both me and my cameraman, Alex. Hi, Alex.
Hi, Tom.
Hi.
Hi.
I speak on behalf of the both of us that we're looking forward to Jethro Tull quite a bit, because Jethro Tull is, well, classic and awesome. So, here we go. Let's see what they bring us. Here is Jethro Tull. He won't give them
Anderson, good night. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Well, ladies and and gentlemen, we just witnessed the performance of Jeff Brotol, the band that says that they were too old to rock and roll and too young to die. Well, I think they should say that it doesn't matter how old they are, they still fucking rock, because that's what they just did. There's nothing more I can add to that. It was really amazing. Up for the final gig of Be Prog 2017, we're gonna look at the antics of the Norwegian band Leprous, who said that they were going to play a very insane set this time because they were doing a by request fan set nonetheless. So I'm really excited. Let's see what they're going to bring to the table. Let's hope it's gonna be a bunch of songs we haven't heard in a while. Gotta be very interesting. Hope it's gonna be worth it. Ladies and gentlemen, this was Be Prog 2017. We just witnessed one of the most intense set lists ever performed by Leprous, I think. Well, at least that's what it looked like. And the audience, well, as you can see behind me, the audience is going crazy. And it has been received very well. My full verdict and conclusion will come later. But I think we can say, as a first response, that this was a very good weekend indeed. Moro Fano. Ladies and gentlemen, Thank you all for watching this documentary about Be Prog 2017. I think I speak on behalf of the both of us that we can say that we had a great time. The ambience was great, the bands were great, and actually considering we had some minor doubts about the planning originally, we were very positively surprised, weren't we?
I was. At first glance I thought there is no contrast between the bands. We don't go from Campbell to, hey, here's Mashuka.
Yeah, it seemed originally that the contrasts weren't as big as on, say, last year with between the Buried and Me and, for example, Magma. But in the end, we were actually surprised. And we go on to the obvious final question, which band did we like the most, or which bands did we like the most? My personal favorite of this weekend was Mike Portnoy's Shattered Fortress, by far, because of the emotional connection I have with that Dream Theater music. And surprisingly, I think that was one of your favorites as well, wasn't it?
It was, and I'm not a Dream Theater fanboy like you are.
Yeah, that says something. Well, I used to be a big Dream Theater fanboy, let's put it that way, but that was a really amazing show, and I get the impression from the audience that the people who were there, especially the fans who were also like Haken, really seemed to dig the intensity and energy that came off the stage there.
It was excellent. I mean, Ross has become an excellent singer. I mean, I've seen him grown over a few years, ever since Haken first played Prog Power Europe until now, filling in for James Labrie. And, well, he made an excellent performance. Eric Gillette, fantastic! I did not know that guy could sing that well.
I know, right? It's like the moment he started doing The Root of All Evil, that was like, whoa, that was beyond anything. So, yeah, Mike Portnoy's Shattered Fortress was awesome. Personally, I also would like to mention Marillion as a, I really don't want to say first or second place or whatever. It's like, you know, all bands were good in their own right, don't get me wrong, but Marillion and Mike Portnoy really stood out. But Marillion stood out to me because they played a setlist filled with epics. Like, that was, well, at least I didn't expect them to play that many epics in one set. I mean, I'm not sure about you, but
I was just blown away by Marillion first time I saw them. And I did not know Steve Hokoff sung with his hands. The guy is so expressive. It's great to watch.
That's true, that's true. And oh well, maybe by that logic, I mean, Marillion was obviously one of the older bands, sorry guys. But let's face it, Jethro Tull on day two? Holy crap. I mean, seriously, if I'm in my 70s and I'm still able to bounce around like Ian Anderson does, then I would be so happy. I would be so fucking happy. I don't know about you, but
you will be prancing around your senior citizen's home.
That would be quite a sight, wouldn't it? Anyway, but just to wrap it all up, thank you all for watching this documentary. It was great fun to be at Be Prog this year. I want to give kudos to the organization for making it a very enjoyable experience indeed. And also basically organizing something that seems so massive with big bands, big in scope, but still feels pretty, well, I'd say cozy and very, very, calm in a way, even though it's a big crowd like that.
Yeah, it is. I mean, I have no idea about the sales fixtures, but it's still the same as it was for the past two editions where I've been to. And the only thing, the only difference is that organizations learn from their faults. Every year they get a little bit better. So now I'm wondering, how amazing will it be next year?
That's exactly my point. Like, indeed, like every time there's little things that need improving and they improve on it and really make it better. So guys, you're doing an amazing job. Please keep doing this. We're already looking forward to next year. And thank you, the viewer at home. Yes, you, I'm talking to you. Thank you for watching this documentary, and hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to share it with everyone you know. And if you see me next year, you can always poke us, because we're probably going to be there with a camera once again. Yeah, like that. Yeah, you can. Okay, you can stop now. you are always allowed to do that. I mean, it's great to see all of you. Thank you, and see you guys next year. Bye!
Bye!
So you want to tell the anecdote and how lucky you are that you're actually here right now?
On a scale of 1 to 10. Probably 12.
Yeah, I'd say 12, 13, right? At least. So what was the situation? You overslept because you're an idiot.
Yes.
We're allowed to say this.
It's allowed to say that I'm a fucking idiot.
And then you overslept.
I overslept through my alarm, sort of. and I was going to be late, so I took a taxi to Singapore, and I'm lucky to even be here because the flight is delayed.
Yes, so in that sense, you're lucky, and we were kind of pissed off, yeah. I guess. Yes, so now he owes us...
I blame his karma.
Okay, so we blame your karma, and...
Karma can be...
exchange for
exchange
coins
for beer.
For beer. Yeah. Okay, I'm totally up for that.
You heard it here first, people. You heard it here first.
Cheers, and enjoy the rest of your day, week, night, millennium, whatever.
Wanna add anything to that ending?
May the Schwartz be with you.
Yes.
Done
it.
That's just funny.
If anyone is able to understand what the fuck just happened.
Our life is very exciting right now.
Really?
Waiting at the airport because we thought there would be a metro strike. So we thought...
Let's be on time.
Exactly. Let's be early, they said. It will be a good idea, they said. And it ended up with the metro still going as it did, without any hinges or problems. So we've already spent about, well, what, 5-6 fucking hours here.
Not that bad. I would say around 3 or 4.
It feels like 12, and we're still basically stuck here for probably the next 2 hours. Yeah, exactly what he says. I don't know what he's saying.
We'll be in the air in 2 hours.
That would be a good idea, yes.
Or at least a second year.
Well, I hope. I would goddamn hope so by then, yes. Tough life, tough life. Hashtag tough life, sad react only.
Sad face, sad life.
What else is there worth mentioning? Alex, help me out here.
Well, don't do drugs, kids. It's very important. And if you do, just do it in a place where no one sees you doing it.
Don't get caught.
Don't get caught doing drugs. That's the morale of the story. Don't get caught doing drugs. We are such a bad influence on people.